Having reached this point in our restoration process and having painted all the parts that need to be black, we're now ready to do something with the trim for the locomotive. These are the various trim parts from the locomotive and the tender. Before much of anything was done to them, they were cleaned up in detergent to remove the huge amounts of grime. But if you take a careful look and zoom in at the picture, you'll see lots of rust, lots of corrosion. Look at the one dome right in the middle of the picture above the brush. You'll see it's pretty corroded. The materials I used for the process include the wire brush that you see, some very fine sandpaper, and some abrasive material. A lot of the items did not even succumb to this much cleaning and elbow grease, and I used the electric drill-powered buffing wheel, which you saw used for preparing the various parts for painting. So if you refer back a couple of videos before, you'll see what that apparatus looked like. But there's no point in repeating it. It's the same thing, just with smaller parts, and in some cases, even the wire brush itself was smaller. Here's an example, a couple of the drive rods. As received, the one up top, after a little bit of cleaning, you can see the one on the bottom, and this still has a ways to go before it's presentable enough to be a companion to the newly painted sheet metal parts. So you'll see coming up what that's going to look like after it was improved. In removing some of the parts, I broke the tabs. They were probably corroded from age. This locomotive was really not in very good shape. And you can see the arrow pointing to a piece of copper that I soldered onto one of the domes. And this will serve as the new tab when this is placed back in. If you don't have both of the tabs there, you'll either be forced to glue it, which is not a good proposition, or let it loose, which is also not a good proposition. So it pays just to make a new one like you see here. It takes a little patience and some solder. You want to tin the inner surface. That's where most of your adhesion takes place, and heat the new tab as you hold it against the dome, and it'll eventually stay there where it should and give you a good result. So after a couple hours of buffing, scraping, wire brushing, and in the case of many of the parts, clear lacquer was applied over them. That includes the valve gear, windows, the domes, nameplates, etc. These are the trim parts for just the locomotive, and there's still, I think we're missing one of the railings from the back of the cab, but I'll just make a new one. That's really not a big deal. The wheels were really pretty nasty looking, but after some buffing, they came up. What I'm going to do with the wheels also is to paint the red spokes. It'll make them look an awful lot nicer. And the valve gear, while it's not spectacular, considering what it started out being, looks a lot better. I was able to find a rivet to replace the one in the one valve gear piece that you saw two pictures ago. So we're ready to start putting our locomotive back together, and that will be the next video you see in this series.